Hello, I'm Mr. Anajur, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity and Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. And here I'm making a picture like this one of the Christianity in a nutshell. In my previous video, I have described John the Baptist, what role he played, and now I am going to talk about this above. This is below, this is above. Here we have arrows which Moses established in the wilderness. That is called the snake was lifted up, rift. And this is above, and here we have agape. Unconditional divine love. We hate none. It is not tribal based, it is international. So that's why Jesus said, I'm greater than Moses. So this is a rough idea which I have presented, and if somebody is interested, then he can join hands with me. I'm not good at technical. And it's very simple, but still, you know, I'm 88 now, so it takes some time to get things done through. So here is what I have revised it, which is in the box. So under ask, seek and knock, which is this one, ask, seek and knock, and that is where the text begins here now. The whole concept of Gnostic Christianity of freedom, total freedom in a nutshell. The royal kingdom of our supernatural father, of our souls, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc., which is Ram Rajya. We call in Indian language Ram Rajya. That means the palace of our supernatural father. The royal vineyard of our supernatural father for his sons, the apostles, to inherit. So in the box, you know, we have the family of God, our supernatural father, experiences extraordinary family love, which is called in Greek storge love, in which you bear 100% fruit, as at Pentecost. At Pentecost, all the apostles, 12 of them which were presented by Peter, all got Holy Spirit with capital S, making them the twin brother of Christ Jesus. So, which extraordinary love called agape, a storge love, in which you remember that there was a woman who married one husband after the other. And when she married the seventh husband, then whose wife she will be in resurrection. And that's where it is here. The seventh husband is the menorah, middle candle of menorah. Which I have here. Oh, here it is. So the seventh husband is this one. This is menorah. These are the Yahweh's creation pots. Three pots here, three pots here. That mean our physical bodies. The light in these pots is lit from the middle candle, which is of Elohim, Allah Pabram, our supernatural father of our souls. Now, in that parable that woman married one after the other, these are the secular one. And when she married the seventh husband, this is the seventh husband, the middle one. That means she remained virgin. And when she married the seventh one, there's neither giving nor taking. That means in the storge love of our supernatural father, there is neither giving nor taking. You are representing father. You are the omnipotent ambassador of our supernatural father. So you can see what type of position you have. Father is father, but he has given all his powers to the sons. Sons are omnipotent ambassador of our supernatural father. That's what he is, the number seven husband. This is very interesting. This thing you get only when you wean off the dead letters of the Bible. Because above, no Bible, as you know that St. Paul said, you know, in 2 Corinthians 3, the gospel cannot be written on ink on paper, but over the living tablet of heart through logical reasoning. So this is the royal kingdom of God, where the gospel is spoken. That's the language our supernatural father understands. He does not understand prayer or fasting. That was to Yahweh. So here only the gospel which is spoken, that is logo. You speak logically and he understands it. You can convey with him. But if you speak illogically, he doesn't want to know you. So those people who are sealed to serve God, they speak logically and they are the one who are saints, are representative, are the sons of the Most High, like Christ Jesus. They are not Christian, they are Christ. I am not a Christian, I am a Christ, because I am preaching you gospel from my own heart. Things I will say, you can look into the books, you won't find it. You have to think it yourself. I go to Oxford University and there is a Christchurch Cathedral, and sometimes I attend their services. So one time I attended it and then I told the dean over there why Jesus was called Yeshua. And I told them Yeshua is made of two words, Yah from Yahweh and Shiva or Shiva means the primal Adam. So Jesus was the firstborn of Yahweh, the second Adam. Mary was sired by Yahweh and she was the surrogate mother of Jesus and Joseph foster father. When I told this thing to him, explained to him, you know, on a piece of paper, gave it to him, oh, I will go home and look into the books where it is written. So you can see what type of reaction you get from men of dead letters. So this above is not for them. It is for those who have Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit is common sense. So here you we go. The family of God, our supernatural father, experiences extraordinary love called storge, in which you bear 100% fruit. As at Pentecost, they were rewarded the very Spirit of God, Holy Spirit. God is Father, Holy Spirit is Mother, and Christ are the sons. So whether in soul, whether you are male or female in flesh, it doesn't count. In soul, you are the sons of the Most High when you represent Him, when you preach gospel, not when you follow somebody blindly. Blind people can't find that narrow gate. Narrow gate is found by those who are people of Spirit, Holy Spirit, as those baptized by John the Baptist. When they found, you know, that if you become Jew outwardly, as the temple priests were making them, then you break your covenant with Abraham and to Yahweh. They came to John the Baptist to be baptized in the name of Abraham. And they were men of Holy Spirit, or they were twice born, most of them. And they were the one who was seeking the narrow gate. So, Christ Jesus and his the sons, Christ Jesus and his solitary virgin brides, the apostles, that is the sons are, you know. This is something written which is a bit difficult for me to read. Let me see, I made a copy of that one. And yeah, here it is. I try to put it yellow, you know, which is the color of the sun, but when you put it, it doesn't appear so good. The fountain of the new wine. Christ Jesus is the very fountain of the new wine. Oral Torah, new wine is just oral Torah that cannot be written down in ink on paper. My anointed elder brother, Christ Jesus, the true wine, Christ Jesus, planted by our supernatural Father, the light to the people of four varnas. Varna are profession, you know. Varna is an Indian word, and which stand for professions. We have Shudra, Vaish, Kshatriya and Brahman. They are the profession. They are not caste, as they are put it in the book by the Stanic people. So four Advent candles. So those are the four Advent candles that you have. And nothing to do with that, oh, you light this one week, this one, second week. No, that is nonsense. So this light is to all the four. Now, this thing has been mentioned by Nanak very clearly. Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. So if you want to understand Sikhism, then you must first understand Christ Jesus, and then you will understand Sikhism quite easily. The solitary virgin brides of Christ Jesus eat the juicy flesh of Jesus. Juicy flesh, you can only hear with this ear, because this is the spiritual mouth, not this one. This is a secular mouth. And this is spiritual mouth, physical mouth, spiritual. Those who have ears to hear his word, that those are twice born. They don't go by what is written in the book, but what they can hear and then interpret it through logically. His word, the gospel, the gospel truth, and they become his solitary virgin brides, the apostles, by preaching the gospel from the rooftops, called drinking the blood of Christ. So people, you know, sometimes they know the things are wrong, but they won't proclaim it. And that people are burying light under bushel. But when you proclaim it, then you are drinking the blood of Christ. For example, this Iraq war, you know, that that Saddam Hussein has weapons of mass destruction. I attend Reading Church's men's breakfast. So I attended, and there was a man who came from military, retired Major General, Rudy Porter. And people asked him, you know, he went to Iraq, and after this bombardment and other thing, they asked him, did Saddam Hussein had any weapons of mass destruction? He said, no, not at all. So Bush and Blair, they were 100% blasphemers. Blasphemer, you know, and blasphemy is not forgivable. So you can see, and blasphemers are super bastards. And the generalist who threw two shoes at Bush, he was a hero. He was a hero in our supernatural father, God, that he understood his their hypocrisy, and he beat Bush, you know, in his face. But most people are deadly, you know. So this man, you know, he had this knowledge, Major General, that they have no weapon, but he won't proclaim it in any church. When only we asked him, then he replied, you know, that means he's keeping the light under bushel, such an important light. So in general, people are, which are nation of shopkeepers, as the British are, they cannot preach gospel. They are the one who's supposed to preach the gospel, because they don't want money. They are quite happy with money, and they can preach gospel. But Indian, where the knowledge is, they want money first, and then they preach. Very few people are there who are devoted to preaching, but they also are misled by the most clever people of Khatri tribe, as they were Judah tribe, Judah Iscariot was misleading their people. So let's carry on. So drinking the blood of Christ when you preach it, such apostles become the fishers of spiritual men that have become solitary away from the traditions. Remember that Jesus said that unless you leave your mother and father, wife and children, for my sake, you have no part in me. Those people who become solitary, thinking that this is the way to go, where the others say, oh, this orthodox is the best way, like Jewish people, they carry on Jewish practices, and one of their family members say, ah, I like what Christ Jesus said. So you want to separate. And that is, you have to do it, you know. You have to become solitary from your families and not bother about them, you know. That's why Jesus, when he was preaching gospel, some Pharisee, Sadducee, or temple priest, had been sent to Mary's, to Jesus' house. And they met Mary, and they told Mary, ah, your son is not doing what is our tradition is. He is misleading the boy, and he is not good. Because they came from the temple high priest, dressed up and other thing, so Mary was quite impressed with them. So she went to call Jesus, come, you are a madman. The temple priests have proclaimed you a heretic. So you have some screw loose in your head. And Jesus said, my parents, my relatives are those who are solitary sitting here. And that is what we are in the family of God. Those who are solitary, leaving their parents, leaving what the others do, but they are the masters of their own destiny, like John 9, born blind person was, then only you can serve humanity and in honor of Christ Jesus to glorify our supernatural Father. Otherwise, you are wasting your life. Life comes once, and this chance is very great for you because end of the age is approaching. I expect the atomic war will take place on 14 May 2023. So let's see what happens. So, because such men, you know, fishers of men, men are those who have left their families and they have become masters of their own destiny, as in John 9, the born blind person was. Away from the tradition and by the grace of our supernatural Father, our brethren get drunk with the new wine to their heart's content. Because Jesus, if you don't know anything, he will explain to you. So you drink the new wine to your heart's content. And through philia love, philia is philosophical love, they become his very fast friends, ready to lay down their lives for his sake, for him, you know. Remember that Lazarus was such a friend of Jesus, and in him, Jesus showed resurrection. So when he wanted to go there, you know, his brother said, don't you know that they want to kill you? And you want to go to Judea region again? But Jesus said he must go to resurrect Lazarus, to tell them the fruit of preaching gospel. So they said, okay, then we also go with you, we die with you. That means the Jews were so hostile against Jesus and they were trying to kill him. But they all risked their life and joined hands with him. And that is the brotherhood we have in Christ Jesus, true brotherhood. So Lazarus was such a friend of Jesus, and in him Jesus showed resurrection, like Father, like sons. Our Father is eternal, so the sons are eternal, the saints. They never die. They never die. Saint Philip said, a Gentile never dies, for he does not live to die. Remember Samaritan man who picked up the wounded person? He was living in God. For him, the flesh does not count, whether it's black, brown, or stranger altogether. And he picked him up, looked after him like his brother in soul. In soul, you know, we have love called agape, unconditional divine love. So that is what he and Philip mean, that he never dies, doesn't live to die. Thus the Gentiles filled the banquet hall at the wedding of the Son, Christ Jesus. It was Judas Iscariot, the thief. He was stealing money from the church, from the purse, you know. He was a thief. Like these dog hole priests in the churches, they also steal money from the church purse as their salaries. And they justify themselves that, it's written there the laborer is worth his keep, which is wrong. Saint Paul said, I have given to the church, I haven't taken money out of the church. Or what apply to the priest, the moral teacher? Opposite apply to spiritual. To the moral teacher, we pay tithe, 1/10 for his living. Opposite, we give to the church rather than take out of the church. So these are thieves of the order of Judas Iscariot, these dog hollow priests in the churches. And you tell them they were justified before men. Remember, when the first church was formed, people sold their possessions to join the first church of God headed by Christ Jesus. And today, money comes first. So you can see these churches are synagogue of Satan's, exploiting people, are creating sectarian riots. So that's why many people are fed up with them. They don't want to talk about religion. And that is the cause of that, you know, because they are antichrist, dog hollow priest. Because everyone has to give his own account to God. They can't give your account, as the Pharisees Sadducees used to do at Passover. So they are worse than those Pharisees Sadducees. Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45 is fulfilled in these dog hollow priests, making the situation worse than before the arrival of Jesus. As our Father Elohim is no more alienated as Yahweh was. You know, Yahweh is the creator of male and female, of nature, pot. He is the potter. And he is demiurge, mean imaginary. He is not real. Elohim is real because his soul in us, which is his son, is inside us. So he is inside us. This soul is to be uplifted to high standard so that you can become spokesman of God, as the apostles were. So God is inside them, and you are speaking what pleases our Father. You become his spokesman. That's why Jesus said, don't worry what to say in the court or in synagogue. Father inside you will tell you what to say. Okay, let's carry on. Banquet hall was filled with these Gentiles, you know them. Very few chosen people came into the banquet. Remember how they were called, they said, made excuses that I have to test the five pairs of bullocks and this and that, you know. So, wedding banquet was the son Christ Jesus, which is a Eucharist, you know. It was Judas Iscariot, the thief, who stole money from the purse, who was thrown out into the darkness. That is why these dog hollow priests in the churches, they have no idea of gospel. They are antichrist. And when you test them or do it, you are throwing pearls before swine, and they turn around and they kick you. As our Father Elohim is no more alienated as Yahweh was. Yahweh is Father in heaven. You know, when people say prayer, our Father in heaven, that prayer was said to Yahweh. In Christ Jesus, we don't say any prayer because Father is inside. Before things come to your lips, he already knows what you want to say. So that's why no prayer or fasting in Christ Jesus, but in Yahweh. So he's no more in heaven. Those people in the churches who say our Father in heaven, they are all super blind, led by their super blind guide with the dog collar, Antichrist. So, as our Father Elohim is no more alienated and as Yahweh was, no more prayer and fasting, but the preaching of gospel through logical reasoning to brew logo. That is what the language our Father understands, logo. No books are needed because we are no more orphans as the disciple of rabbis were after his death, because Jesus, when he made us the sons of the Most High, he has introduced to us Christ in our heart. When the Christ is sitting in your heart, he has boundless treasures of our supernatural Father. Not what is written in the scripture, what these the disciple of John the Baptist and Rabbi Pharisee Sadducee, what is written in the book, that is their limit. And they can't go beyond that one. What is written, they will vomit it out. But in Christ Jesus, because Christ is in our heart, he has the key to the treasury of our supernatural Father. So we can have as many treasures as we like it. We are no more orphans. Because no more orphans as the disciple of rabbis were after his death. Then they will say, who will teach us? You know, he has gone. But living in company of our eternal Father called Emmanuel. Our Father is inside. He doesn't live in the brick-built temple, but in the living temple made by greatest artist, Yahweh, Brahma Khuda. That is, nature is of Khudai, and the Noor is of Allah. So underneath that one, the last one is, one fold, Church of God, one shepherd, our bridegroom, Christ Jesus. And in one London, there was a conference, you know, and I went to attend it. And there were over 400 cults in Christianity. That means 400 folds, like Church of England is Church of Satan, Church of Ireland, Church of Scotland, this and that. That is not one fold. They are out of the fold. So they are blind men defining an elephant. So when I told them, you are blind men defining an elephant, they were not happy. They said, oh, we are happy. Go away. That is our way. So there's on the gate, there's the left side and right side, which is written here. Written here is a gatekeeper, Christ Peter. Gatekeeper, Christ Peter killed two blasphemers, Ananias and Sapphira. Ananias and Sapphira, remember, they sold their possession. They came to Peter. That's all they have got. They had kept some money back in case they have to revolt, to leave that fold. That's why Jesus said, when you are building a barn, you always sit down and calculate that you have enough funds to build it. If you do it haphazardly, then halfway, you know, you say, I have no money, I can't build it, complete it, then you will become a laughing stock among the people. So that's why Jesus said, if you want to join hands with me, come determined and not half-heartedly. As Ananias and Sapphira wanted. So Peter killed them, you know, because they were blasphemer against Holy Spirit. What they were saying from their mouth was different what was in their heart. Heart should be like a little child. What is inside should be outside. So blasphemer, Ananias and Sapphira, truth is the foundation for the gospel truth. Truth, you know, what you see with your two naked eyes is the foundation for the gospel truth. If you are not truthful, you cannot be truthful in God, or you cannot preach gospel. You will give sugar-coated sermon then, if you love money. If you are, these people, you know, they come, sometimes you go to a church, some people come, speaker come from outside, you know, to give them the sermon. And when they had given the sermon, you know, then the elder of the church, he will have an envelope, put it in his pocket. And he is happy, he goes away. So that person, you know, who accepted Mammon, he cannot preach gospel. He will give you, he only can preach sugar-coated sermons of falsehood, which people like, and they make them laugh, you know. And that is what they are there in the church, not to learn anything. So middle of that one is this one. We have a killing of his word, burning bush. You remember Judas, Moses saw the burning bush? That is what it is here. Judas Iscariot hated light. Judas Iscariot did not want to go there in the killing. To the right hand side, here, robber, messianic Jews, that was the priest who was sacked from the temple. They remember the last parable with Jesus' liver of wine press, that these husbandmen, they are no good for any other job than priest. So they were the one, you know, when Jesus died, they put on, when the apostle died also, you know, became weak, and they then jumped over the wall of the Church of God with the written Torah under their armpit. Written Torah is a letters, but our covenant with God is of Holy Spirit, not of letters, Spirit. So they jumped over, you know, the wall like a thief, and they occupied the church because the owner has left the church, you know. They gone preaching or frightened of the Jewish people. And then they started again teaching Torah, written Torah in the churches, which is the Old Testament. You can see they are still reading Old Testament in the church, which is written Torah, forbidden by Christ Jesus. So Jews priest that was sacked from the temple jumped over the Church of God walls like a thief with forbidden written Torah, full of holes, corruptions. So that's why Jesus said, do not take, when you're going on preaching too, don't take any money in your pocket. Because this above, you know, this one here is of the, if the kingdom of sadhus, Melchizedek. Remember I've written here, Melchizedek and other sadhus. Sadhus don't keep money. They are away from the secular wealth, you know. So when you go on preaching too, don't take any money in your pocket, no two shoes, no two tunic, and no scrip. Scrip means Bible is forbidden. Now they change the scrip to sacks. What sacks have to do with gospel? Sacks mean a bag. What bag has to do with gospel? Scrip has to do with gospel, that above no letters here. It is our covenant is of Holy Spirit, and in Holy Spirit you speak logically to brew logo. Here are dead letters, John the Baptist, flying dead letters, scriptures. Here there's a scripture John the Baptist is holding. no book in the hand of Christ Jesus. You will go in the churches, you know. St. Paul was the one who told them, you know, that gospel cannot be written down in ink on paper. And you go to a church, St. Paul's Cathedral in London, you will see St. Paul holding a Bible in his hand. What a contradiction. That means people are spiritually super blind. They have no interest in the gospel, but only in the dead letters. They see, but not perceive. That's why Christ Jesus told the Pharisee Sadducee that you see the dead letters written Torah, but you don't perceive the root of the written Torah, which is Logo, His word. Without spirit, it is dead. That killeth, spirit giveth life. So what I mean to say, you can see how many people can preach gospel. Very few. That is why many are called, but a very few predestined of our supernatural Father are chosen. That is what Thomas said, 1 in 1,000 and 2 in 10,000 will know gospel. So gospel is not that cheap. Now why Jesus had 12 laborers, I have put down here also. 7 were chosen for morality. To be pure, you know, to be pure, you should be morally sound, you should be spiritually advanced. Spiritually sound, that means heart clean, is your heart is clean. Of the 5 husbands of the Samaritan woman, which are the 5 temptation of the heart, then you will be pure. So 7 were chosen for morality, menorah, which is salt of the earth, John the Baptist. Remember Jesus said, I have come to fulfill the law, not to destroy it. And that is why he chose 7 from that. And that reached 70, you know, when they were in the outer circle. And 5 for the spirituality of heart, called Christianity. That is the real Christianity. Christianity is preached by Christ and not by the dead Christians of the book. But in the churches, they are full of dead Christians of the book, and they hate you. Because it's not written there what you are saying. There's 5 husbands of this Samaritan woman. They are well known out to the 6, which are Kam, Krodh, Lobh, Mohankar. They are well known among to the 6. If you ask them, they will tell you. But they can't preach gospel to the Christians, because they themselves are spiritually blind too. They are fanatics. So gospel is by the grace of our supernatural Father. So to be clean of hypocrisy like a little child. That's why Jesus said, unless you become like a little child, you cannot enter into the royal kingdom of God. No hypocrisy. It has nothing to do with the 12 tribes of Israel. That is what they have put down in the Bible, you know. That is wrong. So here is the another presentation of why they were 12. And this is the Jewish menorah, David's cross, 6. 3 on menorah, 3 candle on the menorah, you know, there it is. Menorah, three candle here, 3 candle here. Social, ecumenical, political affair. Some holy and some are evil. Opposite. That's why 2 triangle opposite. That's works. Works. The middle candle is of light, you know, of the God, which they go to synagogue to have it. Without this light, they are dead. Letter killeth, spirit giveth life. So here is the middle candle, menorah, which is of Elohim, Allah, Pabram. And here is the Christianity of heart. Heart is concerned, the five are three of ego and two of mind. Kaam, Krodh and Hankar. These Kaam mean immorality, Krodh mean anger, and Hankar mean haughtiness, of the dead letters, as the university professors are today. If you want to talk to them and ask them simple question, in whose name John the Baptist baptized the Jewish men in water, they have no idea. It is written in the Bible over there, don't you say that you are sons of Abraham? I can turn stones into sons of Abraham. Stone mean thick-headed people, simpletons. And they were clever people in the church, in the temple. So clever people were making them Jew outwardly. And John the Baptist made them Jew inwardly, spiritual. Outwardly, of Semitic race. And they were making them Jew outwardly, breaking their covenant with Abraham, because Abraham was not a Jew but a Semite, and making them anti-Semitic. So in the synagogue today, when they become Jew outwardly, they are anti-Semitic themselves, and they tell the other people that they are anti-Semitic. So you can see what type of truth you can learn through logical reasoning. So this is a six candles of the Yahweh, the middle candle of Elohim, Allah Pabram, and this is the five to clean your heart. So that's why this atomic war is coming in 2023. The AD does not start from the birth of Jesus. It starts when Jesus was 7 years old, when he was in his seventh year. Then it started, you know. That is the middle candle of menorah, Elohim. He was to do the job of Elohim. So, Israel was established in 1948. Plus 70 years, it makes 2018. And now, you know, there are 5 years more of heart, conscience, and that is making it 2023. So, let's see what happens. Remember that the AD started when Jesus was 7 years old. So seven of menorah go away, only five are left of heart, conscience. And that is why the five, you know, the atomic war could take place in 2023. Our Father knows best. And this foolish man doesn't know anything. So those people who believe me, they are spiritually blind. Remember that Samaritan woman, when she found that Jesus was more than a prophet. That when Jesus revealed to Samaritan woman that he is the Christ they are looking for. And she was so happy. She went to village and told everyone that, look, I found the Messiah, but you have to test him yourself, because you can't see Messiah with these two eyes. You have to have the third eye of logical reasoning to test him. So they went to welcome him. Same thing, that was because they were sons of Joseph, faithful sons of Abraham and Yahweh. Salt of the earth. And same thing Jesus told them in the temple, that I am the Messiah you are looking for. Messiah mean that he is representing his supernatural father Elohim. That they retorted that, now you say that you are God, Elohim. We must kill you, not for breaking the Sabbath, but for proclaiming to be the God, Elohim. Many more things I can tell, and not many customers yet. This tribulation will carry on, you know, and so we can see what will happen. Our Father God blesses everyone in agape love, unconditional divine love. Moses established arrows among the tribal people of Abraham, and that was the snake lifted up in the wilderness. That means the rift between the two brethren as they were fighting in Egypt. And Moses told, hey, you are brethren, don't fight. They said, who the hell make you a judge? Get lost. So that thing was gone, rift in wilderness. And that is called lifting up of the snake. If you ask these professors, you know, what color of snakes were they? They have no idea. So gospel is a good news and make you very, very happy. It's up to you to seek. I can't give you. You get it from our supernatural Father when you are eager to receive it. So our Father God blesses everyone agape, unconditional divine love.